7th Floorball World University Championships, now played here in Porto, with 9 men's teams and 7 women teams. And it's a really, really high level competition. You have in some of the teams, for example, Finland, Czech Republic, Switzerland, Spain, you have Korea, you have national team players. I think there is 7 or 8 men's national team players who might be playing in the men's World Floorball Championships later in Riga in December in Latvia this year. The same on the women's who already participated last year. So the level, it's very diverse, the level of the players. Some players are top, really top, semi-professional, professional players from the top leagues in the world. Some others maybe are a little bit doing. But for example, as we can see, the Portuguese who are participating for the first time are making a really, really good effort. And the organization of the event has been enormously well appreciated by the teams and also the IFF and the FISU officials. So I think it's a great event. It's a great way to introduce a new sport to a new market.
It's going really well. The organizer has done a fantastic job. I want to thank them at this point too. And if there has been any problems, they have been solved very quickly.
It's very hard, of course, but our difficult is many. We don't know the floorball. It's first time in Portugal, first event of floorball, World University Championship. And we try to get the best condition for the players because we don't know. But we are normally make good things and organize. We organized last World Cup in 2014, the beach volleyball, and it's a great success for us and for everyone. And we try to replicate the success that we have.
This was a very good challenge for us because the floorball is not developed in Portugal. So the main goal that we have when we are proud to organize this World Championship is to help to develop this sport in Porto. So it's very important for the University of Porto and for the Students' Federation that you are the organizing of this event, that we could help to develop the floorball in Portugal. In the north of the Portugal, of course, and we are here, but also in all countries. We have a huge support of IFF. They help us a lot on that with material and with information. With FISU, of course, FISU help us a lot. And we have also the support of the Spanish Federation. They came here and they are quite good on that. So we are happy. And we hope that we could have the floorball like we have football or something. It's quite impossible, but we try.
One of the most challenging things was really the floorball tradition. We don't have floorball tradition in our country. As you may know, we don't have a federation or an active federation. So we had some help. We have to create formations in some universities all around the country. It was very, very nice because we started the floorball tradition in some universities. With the support of IFF, we can have some material to spread the floorball word around the country, and so it was very nice. In this time, we have two venues. We also provide transportation for the teams, also a shuttle bus to the teams see other teams or even see the city. So I think it's we have great conditions, of course, trying to solve all the problems, trying to get always streaming online to the people in their countries can see their teams playing. I think we did a great job in this kind of aspect.
Hello, my name is Florina Marti and I'm studying at the University of Applied Sciences in Chur in Switzerland. After the last game, I could say I've not a good expression like from the sports side because we lost the last game and that's always a pity, but it was cool to be here. It is another place than we play normally, like in the north or in the east side of Europe. So it's nice to be in the south side in Portugal. I really like Porto. As I said, it's something really different because we are more in the north side with floorball, and now in the south it's a little bit hot to play, but it's really nice with the river and the sea, and we could see a lot of the city. That's cool.
Hi, I'm Martina Čapková, the captain of the Czech national team, and I study at the University of Economics in Prague in Czech Republic. This is a great experience for each of us, because it's in a lovely country that we've never been with the floorball. We have never been to some sea country, so it's a great opportunity for everyone. And we really enjoy it. It's a very friendly atmosphere and everything is quite lovely. Porto is a very beautiful city. I've never been to Porto before, so it's a very good chance to see. And we made some sightseeing, we tasted the wine, and it was really great, everything here.
Hi, my name is Christoph Reich. I'm studying at the HTW Chur and I'm playing for Team Switzerland. It was a great tournament because we can show our skills for the real national team, and it's very nice here to play, but it's a little bit hot here, so it's quite different than in the season. It's a very beautiful town. We had the opportunity to go and watch some different kind of stuff, and yeah, it's very beautiful.
Hello, my name is Laura Manninen from Laura University from Finland. It means a lot because we haven't been ever winning this. It's always been Sweden who has won the tournament, so it means a lot. Yeah, it's great. The organization has been very good, and yeah. Yes, I love it. It's been great here, and I would like to come here again.
Hi, my name is Mikko Kaila from Team Finland, and I'm from Estonian Business School. It's huge, man, because 2 years ago we lost in Singapore in the same event, in the semi-final against Switzerland, and this year we had a special team, and this is like a once-in-a-lifetime experience for some of our guys. So we played pretty solid throughout the tournament, a few bad games, but in the end we were the strongest team and we showed that on the field. Of course, I love Porto. I've been in Portugal once before. I love the nation, I love this city. This is better than Lisbon, I think so. It's been a crazy week, and I have loved this experience.
I think the championship has been run very well. It's been very smooth. I've spoken to a number of the teams and we've all been very happy with the organisation. From competition point of view, the matches have been great. The finals today were unbelievable, really top level floorball, fantastic. And I think they have a lot of experience in organising other events, but this is their first floorball event, so it's very positive. And positive for their play on the court as well. They started the week having never played an international match before. By the end of the week, they've won 3 of them. And I think it's a great step forward. They've had some good support from some of the other federations like Spain, but I think they've now got a really good grounding to now go forward from here. 0 to 10 for the event, we'll go 9.
My general impression about this championship is very positive. We had remembered that floorball is not very known, very popular in Portugal. The organizing committee have not experience to prepare this kind of event. But I think that have done good job. I would like to add that the sport level of the championship was very, very high, and I think we will expect the next championship in Poland, and I think we'll be very successful.
2016, university sport goes on a journey across the world to share its values and its commitment to athletic and academic excellence. This is a year of FISU World University Championships. More than 8,000 students will compete at the 34 events organized in 25 countries, sharing and chasing their long-held dreams. We are International University Sports Federation. Follow your champions. FISU, today's stars.